Now we will go to the callback topic. Open callbacks. Go to his main. Inspect, then console. So what is a callback? Suppose callback is just a function which we pass in a argument or a parameter to other function and execute inside that function. Suppose this is of arrow functions. So there will be the parameter A which will console, there will parameter C, B which will console, and there will be a third parameter which is a function which we will pass a function in that parameter and which we will execute after these two statement. So this is A, we are calling A, we pass the value A equal to 1, B equal to 2, but we passed a function in the place of third parameter. Where is this function? This is this function. So this function has been passed as a function third parameter and this will be executed here. You can see it's live at in the source. We call A here, we debug and this and this. So what will happen? It will come here, then it will go here, then it will come here, then C will call back this function. It came here, then it comes to this body, it console A and B, then it will go to this body. Then done. So we can pass a complete function as a parameter to any function and we can execute that function inside the body of that function. And that is called a callback function. You will understand why it is called a callback just in a second. Now let's see what is an async function. So JavaScript has an async nature. What does it mean? We will see by these statements. Let's suppose where we are consoling one. Let's remove these debuggings. So where we are consoling one, this is we are consoling one. Okay, after that we are what we are doing, we are just executing an async function, means this function. And what this function has? Now this function has an set timeout function. The set timeout function is just like an API. What happens in an API? When we call an API, it can take 2 or 3 seconds, or rather than not 2 or 3 seconds, just suppose it takes 1 second or 2 seconds in bringing back the response. So whatever in JavaScript which takes time is an async function, and whatever can run step by step, not breaking the sequence, it's a synchronous function or synchronous nature. So it a set timeout will take time. It is a function which takes a function as a first argument, arrow function, as we discussed in the some seconds ago, that we can pass a function body which is a callback function, and the second parameter is an input, that how much time it will delay after that function, the first parameter function will get executed. So after 2 seconds, it's an micro nanoseconds. After 2000 microseconds, or let's consider 2 seconds, this first function will get executed. So this complete, we can replicate the scenario of an API. After 2 seconds, let's suppose we are getting in response of console A. So this complete function is an async function. And what happens in JavaScript? It will come to here, it will console one. Now it will get an async function, which is a set timeout function. Now it knows it will take time, which is 2 seconds. So it will completely bypass this function for now it will trigger this function, it will jump to this function, because whenever the JavaScript compiler find an async function, it triggers it, but it jump to the next function. What is next function? Callback function. Go to its definition, it is consoling 3. So what will happen, it will print 1, then it will print 3, and then after it has triggered this, when but it will first console this and console this, and then after 2 seconds it will, this functions, this console log will be triggered. You can see this in action, 1 and this 2. Just ignore this these things. We can track this like 2 async, as you can see it has printed after 2 seconds. Before that many things has been printed. So what our code was, that we will print 1, then we had to print 2, but because in a it's an async function, so it triggered it, but it jumped to the third function. A third function printed 3, so after 1 it printed 3, then it printed async 2. These 1 2 3 are this. So now how to print 1 2 3? I want to print in a sequence. So what I will do, I will use the functionality of a callback function to get that synchronous nature, and how to make an asynchronous nature a synchronous nature. So I will print 1 and 2, and then I will call my async function. The async function is having a set timeout function, means it will take now 5 seconds, so the JavaScript will skip this. But I am using a callback function, I am passing a callback function for an async function. This callback function I am again passing to this set timeout function, and what will happen, this callback function is this function. So after 500 second this method will execute, means after 5 second this method will execute which we have passed, means this method. So 1 and 2 and then this method will execute, but after 5 second, but we have preserved the sequencing. So whatever my point in that is not to make you understand that how to get a sequence right. You can just write the console, shift the console logs upward and downward, and you can shift. But like suppose in this body you have to do some task when after 2 seconds, or suppose you have triggered an API and you have got a reply or response, after that you have to do some task. So what you can do, that you can write your API code, you can pass some callback function like this, and that after getting the response of that API, you can use the callback function after that. So let's suppose 5 seconds it took the response, and that this callback will happen. So you can see that 1 and 2, and then after this callback will call and it will print 3. 1, 2, after 5 seconds 3. This async function is actually coming from this logic. Okay, thank you.